The section 1 of chapter 3, that is vibration, is the Boltzmann distribution. First, let me explain the fundamental concepts of statistical mechanics. The fundamental principle of the statistical mechanics is principle of equal a priori probabilities, which means a state with the largest number of configuration W appears most probably. The entropy S is defined by the number of configurations W. Namely, the entropy S is defined as the Boltzmann constant KB times natural logarithm of the number of configurations W. According to the principle of equal probabilities, the state with the largest entropy appears most probably. The temperature T is defined by the following equation. The inverse temperature is equal to the partial derivative of entropy with respect to the energy. The equation 3.2.2. Namely, the inverse temperature is the rate of entropy increase with increasing energy. Then let me introduce the Boltzmann distribution. The Boltzmann distribution is the number of particles with energy epsilon I in a system with a fixed energy of a particle n and fixed energy E at a temperature T is given by this equation. Small ni is equal to large N, the number of particles, all particles in the system, divided by the sum of exponential function of minus ij over kbt, j equal from 1 to infinite, times exponential function of minus epsilon I over kbt. Namely, this a part is constant, therefore number of the particles with energy epsilon I is proportional to the exponential function of minus epsilon I over kbt. The exponential function minus epsilon I energy of the particle over kbt is referred to as a Boltzmann factor, and the sum of the Boltzmann factor from for all particles is referred to as partition function. Using this Boltzmann factor, the average or mean or expected value of a physical quantity x of the particle is given by this equation, namely by this formula, namely the average of a physical quantity x is equal to sum of xi times number of the particle ni divided by whole number of the particle, which is equal to sum of xi times n divided by partition function times Boltzmann factor divided by n, therefore which is equal to the sum of the quantity xi times its Boltzmann factor divided by partition function, equation 3.2.2. Before deriving the Boltzmann distribution, let me introduce Lagrange multiplier method. The method of Lagrange multiplier is a strategy for finding local maxima or minima of a function subject to equality constraints. Namely, we will find a point AB where the function xy has a minimum or maximum with a constraint g equals zero. So, in this strategy, we define the Lagrangian function L is equal to f plus the constant lambda times g, equation 3.2.3, where the lambda is Lagrange multiplier, which is constant. The necessary condition for the minimum or maximum is the partial differential of L at point AB with respect to x is equal to the partial derivative of the Lagrange function L at AB with respect to y is equal to the partial derivative of Lagrangian function at point AB with respect to the Lagrange multiplier lambda is all zero. Please note that the point AB is different from the points where function xy has maxima or minima without constraint gxy equals zero. Namely, at a equal point AB, of course, gxy equals zero, but partial derivative of g with respect to x is non-zero, and f is non-zero, and partial derivative of function f with respect to y is also non-zero. Let me explain the philosophy of Lagrange multiplier method. We need a reason why we can find the maxima or minima of f with a constraint g equals zero by these three equations. First, let me consider the partial derivative of Lagrangian function at point AB with respect to lambda equals zero. So we take a diffraction differential of L with respect to lambda, and L is function f minus lambda times function g. Then f is independent from lambda, and g is independent from lambda. Therefore, this formula becomes partial derivative of lambda with respect to lambda times g. Therefore, this is equal to g, and from the constraint, this is zero. So this is identical to the condition or precondition g equals zero. Then next, let us consider why the Lagrangian, the partial derivative of Lagrangian function with respect to x and with respect to y are both zero. Because Lagrangian function is equal to this one, therefore, if the partial derivative of Lagrangian function is zero, then it means the partial derivative of a function f with respect to x is equal to lambda times partial derivative of g with respect to y, and with respect to x, the partial derivative of f with respect to y is equal to the lambda times the partial derivative of g with respect to y. Thus, the pair of round f over round x, round f over y is equal to common constant lambda times round g over round x and round g over round y. So let us consider this situation by the this figure. So this curved surface expresses the function of f equals x, function fxy, as which is a function of x and y. So this height is fxy. Then this is a contour of this function fxy. So this is fxy equal d3. On this curve, the fxy is equal to d1, and on this curve, fxy is d1. This is red curve shows the constraints of g equal 0. Here is written g. Then in this figure equal, it is g equal c, but it is not essential difference. Anyway, this condition indicates at the common point AB, the direction of the differential of F and G are common, or the function G equal 0 is parallel to the this curve, this surface on this solution, because it is by factor lambda different. They are by factor lambda different. So when xy point moves on the this curve to keep the g equals constant or zero, then on this point fxy does not change, because on this contour the fxy is constant. Therefore this d1 should be the local minimum or local maximum with the constraint gxy equal 0 or constant. So this is the concept of the Lagrange multiplier. As I told you, the lambda is has a important meaning, which is a ratio of round f round x, round f round y to round g round x, round g round y. So this is a ratio of the change of the fxy in the direction different from the this common tangential direction. And the change of the fxy, this one, and change of gxy, the ratio of this magnitude is lambda. Note that the change of the xy is not on the this curve, because on this curve change of the g and f are both the no change of g and f on this point. Then let us derive the Boltzmann distribution. The given condition is a system composed of a fixed number of n particles with a fixed total energy E. And let us assume n is very large, and the particles have different energies in general, but let us number the energy of the particle I from as epsilon I equal 0, 1, 2, go to infinite, go to very large. And the number of the particle having an energy epsilon I is expressed by Ni. Then total number of particles N is equal to sum of Ni from N equals 0 to large number. And the total energy of the system E is equal to sum of Ni times epsilon I from I equals 0 to large number. So total energy is the sum of the energy of the individual particle times number of such particle. Then let us consider the number of configuration of the system N0, N1, N2, blah blah blah. So the number of configuration W is equal to N factorial divided by N0 factorial, N1 factorial, N2 factorial, blah blah blah. The entropy of the system S is equal to the Boltzmann constant Kp times the natural logarithm of the number of configuration W, then which is equal to Kb times natural logarithm of the factorial of n divided by factorial of n0, factorial of n1, factorial n2, blah blah blah. Then which is equal to Kb times natural logarithm of n factorial minus sum of natural logarithm of ny factorial from n equals 0 to a large number. Using the Starling's approximation, which is the factorial n factorial is nearly equal n times n factorial n times natural logarithm of n minus n. Using this approximation, the number of the natural logarithm of the number of configuration equation 3.2.8 become nearly equal n times natural logarithm of n minus large n minus the sum of n small n sub I times natural logarithm of small n sub I minus small n sub I from I equals 0 to large number, equation 3.2.11, and which is equal to n large n times natural logarithm of large n minus the sum of n small n I natural logarithm of small n I minus from I equals 0 to large number minus large n minus small the sum of small n I from I equals 0 to large number, and this is equal to large n. Therefore this values within the square bracket is 0. Therefore this is equal to large n times natural logarithm of large n minus sum of the small n sub I times natural logarithm of small n sub I. Equation 3.2.12. From here we will find the conditions for the largest W, and in this case the differential of W, natural logarithm W, must be 0 at the largest W. Before considering the differential of the natural logarithm of W, let us consider the dn, d large n. Of course, n is constant, which is 0. Therefore, the sum of d small n sub I from I equals 0 to large number is 0. Similarly, the because energy is constant, therefore the sum of epsilon I, the energy of the ice particle, the ice energy times the differential of the number of a particle with energy EI from I equals 0 to a large number is 0. Then let us consider the dlnw, which is equal to d large n ln large n minus the sum of small n sub I times natural logarithm of the small n sub I from I equals 0 to large number. Then by differentiating this one, we have dn plus n dln minus the sum of dny ln ny plus NIDLNNI. Then, because dn, d large n is 0, this is 0, and ln small n I is d small n I divided by small n I. Therefore, this formula is equal to the sum of d small n I ln n I ln sub n I ln small n sub I plus small n sub I times d small n sub I divided by small n sub I from I equals 0 to infinite large number. Then the d small n sub I is common, therefore this formula is equal to I the sum of 1 plus ln small n sub I times d small n sub I. Then by ignoring 1 unity, this is nearly equal minus ln the sum of ln small n sub I times d small n sub I, equation 3.2.15. Then we apply the method of Lagrange multiplier to obtain the maximum of ln w, which indicates the most probable state under conditions of fixed total number of particles and total energy E. So we produce the Lagrangian function L, which is equal to the natural logarithm of the configuration W plus alpha, one of the Lagrangian multiplier, which is constant, times the number of particle N plus beta, which is the Lagrangian multiplier, another Lagrangian multiplier, and constant energy E. Then we have a differentiation of the Lagrangian function D, which is equal to D ln W plus alpha dN plus beta dE. Then because we have already learned d ln w is equal to minus the sum of ln the small n sub I d small n sub I from I equals 0 to a large number from equation 3.2.13, and dn is equal to the sum of d n I d small n sub I from I equal 0 to infinite, and d is equal to the sum of epsilon I times d small n I from I equal 0 to a large number. Therefore all of them have a d the small n sub I, then d ln w is dl is equal to minus natural logarithm of n I small n sub I plus alpha plus beta epsilon sub I times d n I from I equals 0 to large number, equation 3.2.16. And because this dl must be 0, therefore each of ln n sub I plus alpha plus beta e sub I equals 0 for all number of particle, all I equals equation of 3.2.18. The equation of 3.2.18, ln small n sub I plus alpha plus beta epsilon sub I is equal to 0, provide the form of the Boltzmann distribution because of the presence of ln here. So small n sub I is equal to exponential function of minus alpha minus beta epsilon I, and because of the property of the exponential function, these two factors can be separated and product of exponential function. Exponential function minus alpha times exponential function minus beta epsilon sub I. Then let us consider exponential function minus alpha is constant A. Then we will determine the constant beta. Then the natural logarithm of the small n sub I plus alpha plus beta times epsilon sub I is equal to 0. Then we multiply sum of small n sub I to three terms. And we know from the equation 3.2.9, the natural logarithm of W is nearly equal large n times ln large n minus the sum of ny times ln small ny from I equals 0 to large number. Then from this formula, the first time term is replaced by n large n ln large n minus ln w. Then we multiplying these four terms by KB, we have this equation 3.2.21. Then from the definition of the entropy S equal Boltzmann factor KB times ln W, the equation KB n large n ln large n minus KB ln W plus alpha KB ny sum of ny plus beta kb sum of ny times epsilon y equals 0 becomes kb n ln large n minus s. Because of the definition of entropy s, this second term is replaced by s and it becomes like this. Then the entropy of the system s is equal to kb large n ln large n plus alpha kb n plus beta kb large e, equation 3.2.22. We differentiate equation 3.2.22 by the energy of the system e. Then we have kb, because the first term and the second term is independent from large e. Then from the definition of the temperature T, the partial derivative of entropy S with respect to energy E is equal to inverse temperature. Therefore, beta KB is equal to inverse temperature. Therefore, beta is inverse KB T, equation 3.2.24. Then we will determine the factor A. We substituting the beta equation 3.2.35, beta is equal to 1 over kbt into equation 3.2.29, ln small n sub I plus alpha plus beta times epsilon small sub I, epsilon sub I is equal to 0. Then we have n, the small n sub I is equal to large A times exponential function of minus epsilon sub I over kbt, equation 3.2.37. And we know that sum of small n sub I is the large n total number of the particles. Then n is equal to the sum of A times exponential function of epsilon I minus epsilon I kBt, then the constant A is equal to large N divided by the partition function I exponential function over sum of the exponential function minus epsilon I kBt. Equation 3.2.38. Thus, we have obtained the Boltzmann distribution, small n sub I, the number of particles having the energy epsilon I is equal to the number of total number of particles divided by the partition function times the Boltzmann factor exponential function minus epsilon I over kBt. Thus, it proportional to the Boltzmann factor equation 3.2.39 because the n and the partition function is constant. Let us consider why number of particles with energy epsilon I is proportional to exponential function of minus epsilon sub I over kBt. The probability where state n0, n1, n2, blah 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 appears proportional to the number of configuration W, which is equal to n factorial divided by n0 factorial, n1 factorial, n2 factorial. The entropy of natural logarithm of the number of configuration is S equal KB times natural logarithm W. Therefore, the probability should be proportional to exponential function of the entropy S over the Boltzmann function factor KB. Then, when many particles have the same energy epsilon I, the number of configuration decreases because the change of the number of configuration is natural logarithm minus natural logarithm of small n sub I, the number of particles with energy epsilon sub I. Then the Lagrange, what is the let us remember the what is the Lagrange multiplier. So Lagrange multiplier was a ratio of the change of the function f to the change of the function g, and change of the function f is ln w in this case, and change of the constraint g is number of the total energy. Therefore, Lagrange multiplier beta is the ratio of the change of the number of natural logarithm of the configuration to the energy. So then exponential function of minus epsilon I over kBt is how the number of configuration decreases by energy change by epsilon I increase. So as a result, it is proportional to ni. The if n epsilon I increase, the number of particles with this energy exponentially decrease. So this is the end of the section 2, Boltzmann distribution. Thank you very much.